Hello all, this is 71st Eagle and I am currently flying IL-2 Cliffs of Dover and this is going to be my first record session, so please forgive me if for any slip-ups I make. This is actually my first time doing commentary as well, so hopefully I'll do somewhat well. I'm right now joined by Aries, who is a first-time Blenny pilot, and I'm going to be teaching him on how to fly, and we're going to be bombing Dieppe today.
Hey.
So are you in cockpit, Aries?
Yep.
Okay, go ahead and turn the fuel cocks to the inner and tell me when you have that done.
Okay, set.
Do you have a engine one select key? I forgot to ask you about that. That's what I was forgetting earlier.
Okay, so I gotta start those up separately.
Yeah, you have to
Yeah, I'm
set.
sure I do. Let
Yeah,
me
it's what I
go to
have is
options.
just shift one for engine select one. Shift 2 for engine select 2, and then Shift D for select all engines. Yeah,
Oh, wait.
that's what I was trying to remember earlier.
Shift one, shift two, and both was, what did you say it was?
Shift D, that's how I have it set up.
Apply, back, fly. Okay. I'm back in the cockpit.
Awesome. Okay, hit shift one one. Oh, don't forget, open up your radiators to 60%. Do that
Now,
first.
does yours give you a percentage?
Yes. So probably it would be hitting it 12 times if I'm not remember if I remember correctly. Just tap it 12 times.
Okay, 12. Okay,
Yeah,
those are
just
open.
awesome. And now we can start the engines by adjusting shift 1, then hit I, then shift 2, and then hit I.
Okay, let me back out and adjust the volume.
Okay, take your time.
Okay, that's better. All right, both engines are running.
Okay, go ahead and taxi out of where you are and try find the runway, which is signified with the yellow signs if you see those.
No, I don't. I see you though, so I'll follow you. Do you use your brakes for taxiing or do you just use rudder mainly?
I just use rudder mainly. I'm right now running about a quarter throttle.
Okay, you're on the other side of these buildings. Oh, okay. I can hear you here. I'm right behind you.
Okay. As the engines warm up, I decrease my throttle to about 10% for taxiing.
That's a good temp.
Between 40 and 60 on the oil.
Okay, I'm at 60 on the oil now.
Yeah, open up your routes to 100%.
My oil radiators?
No, just your regular radiators. There's only regular radiators.
Oh, okay. Whoops.
What? Whoops.
I
What?
taxied into a building. I was looking down at my. Okay, let's try that again.
You fine if I go ahead and take off in circle?
Of course.
Just so I can keep my engines cool.
Of course. So, how do I respawn?
Pretty much the same way that you spawned in initially.
So I just
select. Yep, just hit exit, select the map, place. There's now a fireball where you once were.
Yeah. That went well. Alright, back in. So let's try this again. So. Oh, why is my prop pitch all the way up now?
Yeah, it needs to be 100% initially.
Hmm. Dual cock.
Feels good to be back in the Blenny. Quick question, are you faint of heart at all?
No.
Okay. Are you right now spawned in the hangar?
Yeah. I'm gonna move out to the left or the right. I can't tell.
Give me a moment. Are you in the left or right set of hangars?
I don't know, I guess it depends on which way you're looking.
Okay, let me try to see if I can find you and then I'll direct you.
I'm gonna creep my nose out a little bit.
But... yeah, I don't see you right now. I'm going to do a quick check. But... just... don't be alarmed, okay?
Mm-hmm.
So what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to be actually doing a low fly pass over him.
I'm moving.
So he probably won't know what to expect. You'll like the commentary on this, I trust you, because I'm saying some things that I'm not saying to you.
Oh, okay.
It'll make sense later.
Okay, I see my fireball, so...
yeah, head to the direction of your fireball.
Wow.
Well, I screwed that up.
Yeah.
I think I'm missing a little bit more than the damage in one wing.
Okay.
Oh, well.
I gotta remember what my pitch. There we go. I think that was the problem. I didn't have any prop pitch. Oh, now
okay.
I'm moving.
Yeah, I see you.
Yeah, I'm hung up on something. It's not letting me out of this hangar.
What happens if you advance the throttle a little bit more?
I've got it wide open.
100% prop. Are your brakes on?
Yeah, I gotta figure out what button I set for those now.
Well, at least I didn't die during that.
Not the brake key, but it seems like... is there a parking brake or something?
No.
I don't know what the problem is.
Try cycling your throttle. Okay, this time we'll actually be hand to D up. Sorry for about the screwing around. Okay, are you able to move now?
No.
Still no?
Yeah, I'm trying to figure out what's going on here.
100% prop.
100% prop. 100% radiator. Throttle's 100%.
Yeah, then I would just respawn.
Does it get buggy like that sometimes?
Yeah, it's buggy at times.
All right, let's try this again.
Yeah, this will probably be a long video since target's probably about 30 minutes away one way.
All right.
Oh, well, that'll be fine. I'm fine with long videos. That's how I actually prefer them. Prefer doing long, unedited videos. That's how I personally like to watch them. So that's how I'm gonna make them. But if anyone has a comment about that, please let me know down below. I'm gonna go ahead and take off. Just so I can remember what you need to know for takeoffs. Oh, fun. Well, we'll have AI bombers heading to the same place that we're heading to.
Are you sure there's no brake for this thing?
Yeah, there is a brake for this thing, but you have to engage it.
I can't. I don't know what the hell I'm doing wrong. It worked fine the first time. Let's see. Fuel cock. Mixture. Start.
Yeah, don't adjust the mixture from the default.
I didn't mean mixture. I meant my radiators.
No worries.
Yeah, something's not right. Is the prop pitch all the way 100% when it's all the
yes.
way up? Yeah, so I don't know.
Are you not moving again?
Just barely, just so slow that it's ridiculous.
It's probably because your engines aren't warmed up right now.
Well, my oil temperature is at 60.
Oh. Then I'm not quite sure. That's very weird. You know what? I'm gonna try that again. And if I fail, I'm gonna stop recording. But... and that's gonna be going on the video! Whoops! Should figure out the mute key, oh well.
Okay, now my plane is shuddering all over the place.
Is your radiators 100%?
They were at 60, but now they're at 100.
Okay, you might have broken the engine.
Oh my god. Yeah, something's busted. My oil temperatures are down to nothing.
Oh.
Yeah, if I hit escape, it says engine oil damage, engine damage.
Yeah, you gotta let your engines get too hot. You need pretty much taxi once your engines are started.
Yeah, I was trying. It just wasn't letting me. Let's try this again, I guess. Okay. One more time. Try as many times as I can.
Well, if you want to switch, we can switch to fighters, but there's probably not going to be much fighter action right now.
I got to figure it out, so. Alright. Both fuels to enter. Open my radiator
yes.
to 60.
Open it to 100% for taxi and takeoff since you're new.
Okay. And then now I could start, right?
Right.
Okay, seems easy. It's one, high, Engine started, shift 2, I.
I just flew through a hangar successfully.
Okay, both engines started. Nice.
Yeah, taxi pretty much once your engines start up. Then you can choose to go either left or right once you see the runway, which is a brown strip.
And now it's letting me taxi.
Awesome.
All right, so turn right, you said?
Head to your fire if you see that.
No.
Alright, do you see a single lonely hangar to one side? To your left?
Oh, wait, that might be a problem. I hit my brakes button and now it says brakes 50%.
Oh, then that might be it. Hit your brakes key again.
Yeah, it's not doing anything now.
Yeah, I'm thinking that's their problem. There, you can actually hit the brakes key. Do you see where it says full wheel brakes? It's on your control yoke.
Yeah.
Just tap that and it should.
Oh, yeah, now it's at zero.
Yeah, so don't tap your brakes.
Oh, there's my fire. Okay, let me spin around here then.
Yeah, I see you right now on the ground.
Gonna ground loop real quick, go over there.
Copy that, or you can use your engine controls and select one engine and do full throttle, spin around.
Oh, okay.
Then just head left or right, whatever your favorite direction is. Away
once
from.
Once I get to the fire.
Turn to your left.
Oh, I see it now.
Yeah, you see the runway now?
Mm-hmm.
I just flew over the runway, so you'll want to head that direction. Yeah, the Blenny is probably my favorite aircraft in the game. In fact, the most kills I've ever gotten in one sortie for in terms of air to air has been in a bomber.
Nice.
So, I'll make sure you're a good bomber pilot. Even though XZ probably would prefer having a good fighter pilot. Okay, go ahead and turn to your right, make a 180 on the runway, then turn it off. You'll need to apply a left rudder. When you're doing the takeoff roll. So, go ahead and take off.
I don't need flaps or anything?
Nope, you don't need flaps.
Alright, 100% throttle?
Good luck.
Yeah, we'll see.
Yeah, sorry if my low passes are annoying.
They're not, it's alright.
Yeah, I've actually hit some people by doing this, but I'm keeping a few extra feet of distance. I'm not going as low as I usually like to.
Okay, and rotate.
Awesome.
And I'm up. Gear?
Yep, gear up. Pull up, pull up, pull up. up some more. Okay, go 100% throttle, 0% prop, and turn on your boost. Do you copy all of that?
Yep, got it.
You have me inside. Tell me when you're at 200 miles per hour.
All right, I gotta figure out which one's my airspeed here.
It's directly under your oil temps.
Oh yeah, okay. I'm at 140.
Go max throttle.
Do I need to level out? You want me to level out? That's probably why I'm not speeding up. There we go.
Yeah, just follow me.
Where are you at?
Directly in front of you.
You are?
Yeah. Or I'll turn around. Try to see.
Are you on the coast?
Yeah.
Oh yeah, I see you. Head over there.
Yeah, just follow me. And go max throttle.
Yeah, it's maxed out.
Okay.
Alright, I'm at 200. What's the max speed on this thing before I break it?
Probably about 320. The max that you'll get in level flight with the current load that we'll have is about 260, 270 if you get really well trimmed out. Do you have visual on me?
Yeah.
Okay,
just hitting the coast now and turning it towards you.
Roger. Tell me if I get too far ahead.
No, you're pretty far up there.
Okay, I'll slow down some. Okay, I'm turning south.
Now, of course, my trim isn't working. Ease I bound.
Aw.
Oh well.
Excuse me. So now we're just going to be crossing the channel. Do you see a visual on me? I'm right now feet wet.
Yeah, I see you. I tried to cut your corner and catch up to you a little.
Okay. What airspeed are you right now at?
Looks like about 240.
Okay, I'm right now on 240 right on the dot, and I'm not going full throttle, so I'll pull back a little bit.
Yeah, I gotta look down and manual trim because my trim keys aren't working.
Yeah, we'll get those figured out after this flight.
That was too much. Let's see. There we go, that's pretty good. Yeah, I'm at 2200 now because I was dicking with the trimming.
That's fine. I'm currently going 2300. Or not 2300. Yeah. That would be crazy fast. 230.
Yeah.
Are you able to follow me all right?
Yep.
Tell me when you've caught up and then we can go full throttle.
It might be a minute.
That's fine. No rush. You're learning fast. If my calculations are correct, we'll hit landfall and then turn left to head for the airfield. So, what do you think of how this sim looks?
It looks really good. I don't know if it's the default or the patches, but yeah, it runs really smooth and it looks pretty good.
Yeah, there was a huge shaky start to this.
Yeah, I was reading some of the dev blogs on Steam and it looks like a lot of people were pretty unhappy for a while.
Yeah, Team Fusion changed it a lot. And hopefully sometime this summer, Team Fusion 5.0 will come out, but I'm not sure when that will be.
What's that supposed to change?
It's gonna add a new theater and a ton of new aircraft, like almost effectively doubling the aircraft count in game.
Cool. I think I like the Battle of Stalingrad, Battle of Moscow and everything, but I think they should do US versus Japanese.
Well, that's actually coming to DCS in the near future, believe it or not.
Oh, is it?
Yes.
That'd be cool.
Yeah, it's gonna be a F4U Corsair as the main aircraft initially. Then it's going to have other developments. And if you want, I can actually probably get you configured with DCS later and also Falcon BMS. Because I think you'll like that if you liked Falcon 4.0.
Oh yeah, that was so long ago.
Yeah, I'm actually hosting an event tonight called Falcon Fridays. So if you want to come by and get everything set up, I can get you set up with BMS and you can fly tonight.
Maybe, we'll see. My wife gets off work early because Easter and whatnot, so.
Yeah, time it will be 7 p.m. Eastern.
So it'll
But
be four.
yeah, probably come around 3 for you just to get here early because setting up controls is a little bit hard and it takes a little while.
Yeah, we'll see. I don't know. It's gonna be a busy weekend for me. But yeah, if we can. I'm trying to redo my backyard too, so.
Yeah, not a problem. Yeah, I just am right now trying to avoid some work that I need to do myself.
Yeah, I mean, I'm going to school full time, and my work and life.
Yeah, we're right now crossing the channel at one of the widest parts.
Yeah, I can't seem to go any.
How fast are you going right now?
220.
That's weird.
It's my radiators.
What's your radiator saying right now?
Oh, they're at 100%.
Set decrease them to about 60, so about 8 clicks. And that should give you a little extra speed. When I usually fly, I actually fly at 45. So I get every little speed that I can get. Sometimes I'm even a little bit daring and do 40%, but 45% is usually a safe bet. Yeah, and as for IL-2 Battle Moscow and Battle Stalingrad, I don't foresee them doing anything like that in the future because they're a Russian company.
Yeah.
But time shall tell. Maybe you'd use that for all Eastern Front, and then use DCS for more late war stuff, and then this will be serving as a niche for early war. Does that all make sense?
Yeah.
So each one has their own purpose.
Yeah.
I personally prefer early war stuff, but
I like it all.
Yeah, but there's ships to the side of us. Do you want to go for those?
Whatever you think, yeah.
It's whatever you want to do.
I don't mind. I'm easy. I'm just learning, you know?
Okay, let's go for the ships. Do you see the dots to about 11:30?
No.
Okay, we'll pop up a little and see if we can get some ships. I'm heading straight for them right now.
What's the render range?
The overall render range on this game, I'm not sure. I think it might be 100 miles or something crazy like that. Because I know I can't see further in any other game that I know of, even DCS.
Because I see you, I just don't see the ship, so I don't know if they're rendered for me yet. Oh wait, oh yeah, they're just now rendering.
Okay, good. Yeah, we'll just go for the ships and then RTB. So, you know, I assume your probably best tactic for taking out ships is a shallow dive bomb, so similar to how you do the PE-2.
Mm-hmm. With 11 seconds, though, does that make a difference?
Yeah. Yeah, you'll probably need to lead the ship some. But typically most people, when they fly, they use 11 second delay, but I personally prefer the 1 second, and 11 seconds is easy for teaching.
Oh, okay. Yeah, the water looks really good in this game.
Yeah, it's a really nice looking game, I would say.
Does it have weather, like storms and stuff?
That's actually not properly implemented in game, but Team Fusion is working on it, I think. I'm not 100% sure. But you can pretty much make your own weather, but it's a little laggy on the system, so I'm going to be going for the second ship. You can go for the first ship, and we'll drop bombs on them.
Okay.
So by first ship, I mean the closest ship.
Oh, alright. It was actually the back one, it looks like, for me.
Yeah, just go for wherever you want and watch out for flak. Because flak can be very nasty.
Yeah, same shooting at you.
Hopefully I got that ship.
All right. Diving on this one now.
Roger. Yeah, I haven't gone after ships in a while, so I'm a little unfamiliar.
Okay, I hit the button, but I didn't hear anything happen,
Yeah,
so we'll see.
I saw your bombs go. So don't worry about your bombs did go.
I missed by a lot.
Did you drop two?
I dropped them all.
Oh.
Looks like. Oh well.
Yeah, you don't get any, like, solid reverberation like you do in Battlestone Red.
Yeah, you don't get any feedback, let you know.
There you go, there's a hit. Or at least somewhat of a hit. It's not really damaged at all. Try to see if I can get a fireball one for you. Yeah, the ships look nice when they blow up. You still have visual on me?
Yeah, I'm watching you.
Okay. Left or right?
Left.
Yeah, I need to get back into the practice of bombing ships because I used to be relatively good, I think. Did that bomb go off?
I guess it must have. I didn't see it go off, but I see the ship smoking, so. Or no, that might just be a smokestack.
Yeah, it's probably the smokestack. I'll go in again.
I didn't see it go off. I don't know.
Yeah, that was really weird.
You sure you're not out?
Hey, let me check. Yeah, I still have one bomb left. Let's make this last one count, and hopefully I can get you a nice explosive. For some reason, the AAA is focusing on you versus me.
It was focusing on you. It wasn't shooting at me. That looks far. Or that might be them shooting flak at you, I can't tell.
Well, I'm right now watching.
I think you overshot it.
Yeah, I don't see it going off for some reason. Oh well. Okay, let's form back up and head north. R2B.
Okay, I'll let you pass under me.
Yeah, I'm right now just passing under you. Turn left or right. Do you see me?
Yeah. Get you here in a sec. Yeah, I'm on your, like, 7 o'clock.
Copy. I'll hold about 220 for our egress.
Oh shit, I'm going way too fast.
I can go faster.
I'm gonna
I'll punch it. I'll punch it and go faster. So, do you have any interest in learning the SU-25T in DCS?
Yeah, I mean, is that's the stock one, right?
Yes.
Yeah, I mean, I jumped in there and did a training mission. That's all I've done on it. My problem is I don't speak Russian. Hard to read all that crap.
Well, you can actually change it to an English cockpit.
Really?
Yeah.
That would be extremely helpful.
We can help get that set up, but after this, I'll give you a basic overview of flying the Hurricane, which is the main fighter that we use in the campaign. Are you caught up with me?
Yeah.
Yeah, I see you right behind me. I'm actually using autopilot, hence why my aircraft is flying sort of askew.
How do you do that? That sounds convenient.
It's on something that you can do with cockpit clicks.
Keybind.
Yeah. Yeah, it's just something that I can help you set up later or after that. So, what do you think of the Blenheim?
Fun. It's actually a lot more maneuverable than I thought it would be.
Yeah, we're gonna lose some of the maneuverability, but it's gonna gain some toughness in
Yeah.
the next patch. Hopefully we're gonna get the bow fighter, which I
That would
would
be cool.
love that. Four
Could
20 millimeter cannons.
shoot rockets.
I don't know if the model that we're gonna get has rockets. Are you following me all right still? Okay, good. Just wanted to make sure.
Hey, stop that dog. Sorry.
You're fine.
Gonna turn off my microphone so I can yell at her.
So this has been my first time doing commentary as a part of a
Sorry
live
about that.
flight. Not a problem.
I got like a rug and she decided it was dirt and wanted to dig in it, and my wife's gonna be pissed.
Ugh. Yeah, you'll have my endorsement for joining in 71st if XEX around, but I think you'll get in. You're a good guy.
I mean, even if I don't get in, I don't, you know, it's one of those things like I would love to be in, but I don't necessarily want to put a tag in front of my name because I suck so bad. Like, I need a lot more practice, but it's just fun to fly with somebody to teach you because, you know, it's hard to learn on your own. It's easier when you got somebody to talk to, give you the ins and outs of different aircraft and stuff and how to fly them.
Yeah, I'm better with the bomber slash attack aircraft, so that's my specialty. But I can pretty much fly anything in this game. So if you want to learn German aircraft, I'm the guy to ask because pretty much everyone in the squad is exclusive to British. Because we are a British
squadron, yeah.
Yeah. Where do you know what the 71st Squadron was in real life?
I don't.
It was an American or British Eagles squadron, where it was a squadron consisted entirely of American pilots.
Oh, because like the mercenaries.
This was before the U.S. involvement. So,
right. Like the Flying Tigers in China fighting the Japanese.
Exactly. You see the coast in front of us?
Oh yeah, I guess so. See it off to the right, at least.
Sorry, I need to fix my trim. I just turned off autopilot.
Oh yeah, that's one thing I need to do after this flight is adjust my trim settings, because it's hard to look down and scroll that wheel. Does this thing have guns?
Yeah.
Oh, yep, I guess so.
I just saw your shots land in the water. Yeah, I don't have track IR, so that's probably good.
How do you play without track IR?
A hat switch? That's how I've been doing all my life.
Man. And once you go track IR, man, you're never going to go back.
Yeah, I'll probably do that in May or something, maybe. I don't know.
You know what I need is a better monitor. Hey, I don't have a 1080p monitor. I just got a cheap one.
Well, it's perfectly fine. How big is it?
Oh, not very big. It's I don't know. I'd have to measure it, but it's not very big.
I'm playing on a 15-inch laptop.
Oh, yeah, it's bigger than that. Oh, a laptop? Oh, that sucks.
Well, I'm getting pretty smooth frames, and I think it's working well with recording so far.
Yeah.
But the video will tell, and...
Yeah, I guess we'll see, huh?
Yeah. Yeah, we'll figure out landing. Okay, go ahead and turn off Beast Cutout. For landing, you'll need to have 100% prop, 100% rad, and then probably about 20% throttle, but don't do those settings right now.
Okay.
I'm going to turn more directly north and try to figure out exactly where we are, and then we'll return to base. So, the first sortie that you've had... that you got off the ground was a successful sortie back.
Yeah.
Don't expect that to happen too much in a Blenny.
No. Well, we haven't landed yet. You don't know my landing skills.
Yeah, and for landing, I would actually recommend flaps, so.
Yeah.
You can pop up some altitude-wise and get a bearing on our location. Any questions about the Blenheim that I can answer?
Not yet. It's pretty straightforward. Pretty easy aircraft to fly.
Yeah, the weird thing is the British bomber is easy to fly, relatively speaking, but the German bombers are hard to fly. The Italian bomber is just trollish, I would say. It's fun to fly, but it doesn't have too much practicality to it.
In Battle of Stalingrad, the HE-111 is lots of fun. The problem is it's like trying to fly a pig. Like, to get it to an altitude that keeps you relatively safe is almost impossible.
Okay, I think I know where we are. Yep, I know exactly where we are, so we're just going to turn up the coast to the left. Yep, we're exactly where I figured us to be.
That's good.
Yeah, so our airfield should be to our 12 o'clock. Yep, found it. So, do you want me to land first so you can see a landing approach, or do you want to land first?
You go ahead. At a circle.
Okay.
What's your landing speed?
Typically around 120. Okay, I'm gonna get ready to land, so go ahead and circle the airfield. It's directly ahead. Gear speed is 160. Time to land an aircraft that I have not had a chance to land much in recent history because I've been mostly flying the Hurricane. Yeah, and probably tapping the brakes is key for landing.
Yeah, it's gonna suck because I gotta use that switch on the steering wheel and not a keybind.
Yeah, approach speed about 130 and then touchdown around 120. Change at approach speed to 135. Lowering the flaps. And for when we do the Hurricane, we'll probably just do a few circuits around the field because there's not much in terms of enemies.
Right.
And they would be with significantly superior aircraft to us.
Why do you guys fly Hurricanes and not Spitfires? Is that just to do with realism? Immersion?
Yeah. And how the campaign file is set up.
Alright, I just saw you land. So I'm going to go back to the south to make my approach.
Roger.
You said 100% prop and 100% radiator, right?
Right. That was a really clean landing by me. Normally I don't do that well.
Well, wait, you watch this.
You're gonna do just an amazing landing.
I'd be pretty surprised, to be honest with you. I gotta bleed all the speed off first.
Do you know how to cause what you call it? Side slip?
How to cause it?
Yes. That's the
No.
best way to okay,
Oh,
tilt.
use your rudder?
Yeah. Use your rudder and then apply aileron to keep level flight. If you do that, that will just bleed
Oh
speed to
yeah,
like
holy
nothing
crap.
around.
Yeah, that worked, huh? Okay, my gear's down.
Are you approaching from the same side that I did?
Yeah.
Okay, I'll be watching you. Yep, I see you right now. So, no pressure. It's gonna be all on camera.
Flaps up, flaps neutral. And now they're not
Flaps
going.
down.
It's not going down. Where's the flap key in the cockpit?
Flap key.
Or I guess I'm gonna do it without flaps. We'll see.
Yeah, I'll try to see if I can find them. It's a yellow piston, toggle landing flaps. It's
Where at?
a back one. If you look down where your trim
Oh, yeah.
was, it's that.
Okay. Oop, that put him in neutral.
Yeah, pit them down. You'll get a nose down force just as a heads up.
There we go.
Just land her gently. Time for no pressure landing.
No
You can
pressure.
do.
The brakes are going to be the issue.
Looks good so far.
So far.
It's better than my first landing so far. Looking good. Okay, lower down.
Nope.
Oh, little too hard on the brakes. That's what happened.
Yeah, and it
That's why I
sucks.
said to pulse them. So we'll
Yeah,
get
well,
those.
that's what sucks is because when I tap that lever, it 100% automatically. Like, there's
Right.
no. Ah, but, well, I'm alive. My crew's alive.
Yep. Nice landing for your first time. It was better than mine. It's better than flipping your aircraft completely over.
Well, cool. Now I know which keybinds I need to work on now. My trim, my flaps, and my brakes.
Awesome. Okay, I'm going to conclude this. So, thank you all for watching the video. Please leave a comment and subscribe if you do feel like you want to subscribe. Thanks.